everybody. Welcome to another episode of Dirt Nap City. And today it is another Dirt Nap City dead end, where we talk about things that used to be popular and aren't anymore. Some still exist, some are completely gone. And I'm going to tell you today, Alex, that the one I'm going to talk about, if it's not already completely gone, it totally should be.
Oh, I like these. I like these. These are fun.
Let's go back to, I'd say, around 1924. There was a man. His name was Alvin Kelly. And he had been a sailor, but probably not a very good one because his nickname was Shipwreck.
Wow.
And he started a fad that kind of went on for quite a while, but eventually died out in every place except the Netherlands. Still exists in the Netherlands today, actually, but everywhere else it's not really a big thing. He was one of the first people to ever sit atop a flagpole. Now, you've heard of flagpole sitting, right?
Oh, man. I hear it's one of those things you hear about and you go, wait, what?
Yeah, exactly. Exactly. Alvin Shipwreck Kelly, not to be confused with this guy here, your host, he set the very first record of flagpole sitting outside of a Hollywood movie theater as a promotion for the movie theater, basically just to attract attention. He was hired by the movie theater owner. So maybe that was who really started it. Guess how long the first flagpole sit was.
So first of all, I want to know what it is. You climb up to a flagpole and you just sit.
Yep.
You just put your butt on where the top of the flagpole is.
No. They put a chair. I didn't know that. Yeah. There's actually a flat surface that's erected on the flagpole and sometimes safety harnesses so that you don't fall out. But this was the first guy to do it. So it may have been a lot cruder for this one.
All right. So you're balancing a chair. Are you balancing it? Like, is that why it's hard?
No, there's nothing difficult about it other than the monotony and the stupidity of it. But actually, you're literally just sitting there on a flat platform that's slightly bigger than your butt.
But if you're scared of heights, it might be.
Yeah.
But this isn't like some kind of David Blaine stuff where it's dangerous.
No. This is literally flagpole sitting. So Alvin Shipwreck Kelly, first time, does this to promote this movie theater in Hollywood. How long do you think he sat up there? And keep in mind that this was the first time it was done. So maybe they didn't have a platform. Maybe he did sit on that little ball at the top. You know,
well, that would change my answer, though. I don't know. A day?
13 hours and 13 minutes.
And then what? He got bored?
He got down. I mean, he probably had to pee, right? I mean, come on. 13 hours and 13 minutes atop a Hollywood flagpole outside a movie theater. Well, this did.
Was it for a promotional deal? Like, was it promoting a movie or something?
I don't know if it was a specific movie or if it was just to get attention to the theater, to get more people to come to the theater.
Right.
And it worked. People, news got a hold of it. Remember, this is 1924. So, you know, this was big news in those days. And people started copycatting it and doing it in other cities and sitting in other flagpoles to try and get attention on things. So 3 years later in 1927, he actually shattered the record at the time. So after he did his 13 hours and 13 minutes, copycats emerged and outdid him, you know, did longer and longer. Well, finally he does it again in 1927, went from 13 hours to guess how long.
Now I'm going to say over a day.
8 days.
Now we're talking.
Yeah. Yeah.
So I don't even want to know what happened when they had to pee.
And then it went back and forth. There was a guy who did 21 days and then 49 days. Kelly kept battling with all these, basically people would challenge him, break his record, and then he would go and do it even longer.
And they literally wouldn't get down, or would they take breaks and then resume?
No, they wouldn't get down
for 49 days.
Yeah, so a guy named Penfield went 51 days in Iowa and broke his record in front of 20,000 onlookers, like had people all around him. I guess Iowa, it's probably a cornfield or something.
And then, like you say, so, and then what? It's like the dumbest thing.
Well, so first of all, in answer to your question about going to the bathroom, you know, Shipwreck Kelly was interviewed a lot of times about how he did it. And he's said to have had a tube that went from his body down the flagpole for waste. And he also smoked a lot of cigarettes. He drank a lot of coffee. You know, they would hoist it up to him. These things would be, there weren't drones at the time, so they would hoist up the stuff. But he would start, he started charging admission for these things.
To watch and him? They,
yeah, yeah. If you wanted to get up close and see him, you had to pay admission. God. And at one point, they estimated he was making $100 an hour sitting on this flagpole.
You go and you look at him and then you go, yep, that's a guy on a flagpole.
Yeah. Well, I don't think one person, you know, you had to have lots of people paying a nickel each, right?
So. I mean, then, but then you go, how long are we going to stay and watch this guy? Like, there's no risk that he might fall off.
Well, they didn't have TV. They didn't have the internet. I mean, this was about all that was going on.
I think
back
this
then,
was so. In Houdini's time, though. This was yeah. in Houdini's time. Yeah. So they did have him, but he had to wait for him to come around to your city. P.T. Barnum.
Yeah, yeah. Well, so you and I have been to New Orleans a couple times. He spent 80 hours at the Jung Hotel on Canal Street in 1928 in New Orleans. He was aiming for 100 hours, but was blown down by severe weather and had to stop after 80. And then in 1927...
You glossed over... Somebody getting blown down by severe weather. Was he okay? How tall are these flagpoles?
Standard flagpole height. SFH. I don't know what that means. Standard flagpole height.
Is that 20 feet, 50 feet, 80 feet?
I'd say 25 feet probably.
All right. So if you got blown off of one by severe weather, it seems like that could.
I don't mean damaged. He fell. I mean, he had to climb down.
Oh, okay.
Because the weather forced him to retire. Now, in Kansas City, he did 146 hours at the Westgate Hotel. That was more than 6 days. And the temperatures went down to like 17 degrees Fahrenheit. And so that was definitely a tough one. In St. Louis, he broke his own record by doing 169 continuous hours.
And at this point, Shipwreck Kelly is like, what did I start? Like, I did this for 8 hours as a joke, and now these people are doing this for months on end. But do you think he was proud of himself, or was he mad that people kept breaking his record?
He was making money. He didn't care.
He made the money.
Yeah. He was. I mean, I'm sure he shared it with whoever owned the flagpole. You know, you had to have the flagpole rental. But yeah, he was getting famous. He was being interviewed. He was often satirized in the newspapers and magazines of the times. I mean, Shipwreck Kelly was a pretty big deal back in the 20s for flagpole.
I'm going to start calling you that, by the way.
I'll take it if I can make $100 an hour for sitting here. He did use rope stirrups to keep his feet balanced, and also had like a harness that would keep him from falling off. But he didn't sleep. He would just take quick little naps. And like I said, he didn't really eat solid food. He mostly drank broth, coffee, and smoked a lot of cigarettes, and basically, you know, went through a tube that carried his waste down to the ground.
That's disgusting.
Now, do you know the difference between a flagpole sitter and a pole sitter?
Well, a pole sitter, I mean, in like literal pole sitter, or like in the, okay, because in auto racing, you have a pole sitter.
No, that's what I meant. That's what I meant is your pole position, right?
Right.
Also in horse racing, that would be the inside, you know, best position to start from is your pole sitter.
Right. It's the pole person position. Who's on the top, right?
Yeah. You don't want to get those two confused though.
Right. Definitely not. Especially if you have to put human waste in the tube.
So this did start, in, you know, 1924, and it really kind of fizzled out by the 1930s. Had about a 10-year run of popularity
during the Great Depression.
Yeah, I guess so. I mean, you know, it's what people were doing. But however, pretty much once a decade in the 40s, 50s, 60s, 70s, somebody would come and break a new record. And so the current record of flagpole sitting was set in 1984. Take a guess how many current days. Record? Yeah, the current record. Don't Google it.
Oh, man. Just guess. I won't. It's one of those things that I don't care enough to Google about. I don't know, 80 days, 90 days, something like that?
439 days, 11 hours, and 6 what? Minutes.
It's by over a year. H.
David Werder, W-E-R-D-E-R, yep.
And he wasted a year of his life up on a flagpole.
Well, we're talking about him, right? And he's probably still alive, David.
So Warner. Just so two podcasters could talk about him 40 years later, he did this, wasted a year of his life.
Well, there is actually in the Netherlands, the Dutch have a sport called paalzitten, which means pole sitting. Now, it's a little different on this. What happens is they actually sit on wooden poles with a little bench at the top. But the poles aren't flagpoles. They're lower and they're over water. And usually they do it in the wintertime when it's really cold and the water's really cold. And so whoever can sit in their on the flagpole or on the pole in this paalzitten wins. And that's still done in the Netherlands today.
It just doesn't seem like a spectator sport to me.
I think we should go to the Netherlands and go to the paalzitten World Championship.
Man, I can think of a lot more fun things to do in the Netherlands than that. It just doesn't seem like something I want to watch. Like, where's the excitement in watching it?
Oh, man. I mean, I think what you're doing is just drinking a lot, honestly. Oh,
okay. How long do you think you could sit on a pole?
Oh, 10 minutes.
And because what? You'd be bored? Other things to do? You have to go to the bathroom?
I feel like I was wasting my time, yeah. I would definitely be bored and annoyed. It's just anything that sort of endurance thing. Also, I have to have my sleep. Like, I do not do well without sleep. So I don't think I could sit up there long enough to miss, you know, one night of sleep.
Really? Do you think you would fall if you fell asleep? Would you be afraid of falling?
You know, there's two weird things. One weird thing I was going to tell you real quick is that the record for paalzitten at the World Championship was 92 hours compared to 400 and something days.
Yeah, that must be a lot more difficult. I wonder how much balance is involved. Are you really balancing up there? Or are you just sitting? In which case, then it's just like the world record for sitting in a chair.
Well, I think there's probably a little bit of balance because if you look at pictures of these people, there's not anything behind them or beside them, right? They're on a flat piece of wood. So this is always something that has fascinated me is do you ever worry about falling out of your bed at night?
I don't.
Okay. If your bed was 25 feet in the air with no guardrails on the side, would you worry about, and you had to go to sleep?
Yeah, absolutely. I don't like heights.
Isn't that a weird thing, though? Because you can go to sleep confidently every night and with a 99.9% assurance you're not going to fall out of bed.
Yeah.
But if it was up in that height, you would be like, oh, I'm going to roll out for sure.
Yeah. You ever see these pictures of these hammocks that are up in the in the mountains?
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. People are just over thousands of feet. Yeah, it gives me sweaty palms when I see those.
I'm going to leave it with the 80s or 90s hit by the band Harvey Danger. You know the song?
Pole Sitting?
It's called Flagpole Sit Out.
Let's hear it.